Okay, let's look at chemical formulas now. As we have mentioned earlier, the chemical symbols of elements are actually found on the periodic table. So we have our metals on the left side of the imaginary zigzag line and the non-metals on the right side of the imaginary zigzag line. Okay, when we are writing chemical formulas of the substance, we have to know how to write the cations as well as the anions. So let's recap a bit. Cations are actually positive ions, and they are formed when an atom loses one or more electrons during a chemical reaction. For cations, it is usually formed from metal atoms because only metal atoms will be giving away electrons during bonding. Okay, so an example, we have the group 1 metal elements. For lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium, they all have one outermost electron on the outermost shell, so they tend to be giving away the one outermost electron, so the formula will give you a plus 1. Okay, when we write the formula of the cation, make sure we have the symbol of the cation written. And the number 2 here actually will represent the number of electrons that are lost, and the positive charge will represent that it is a cation. So in this case, for group 1, it's just a plus 1 charge because they are only losing 1 electron. For group 2, they will all have a plus 2 charge because they will be losing 2 of the electrons in their outermost shell. Okay, the same goes for group 3 with a 3 plus charge. Okay. And the transition metals are actually a little bit special because the charge actually comes from the Roman numbers written here. Iron 2, iron 3 will be iron 2 plus and iron 3 plus, while copper 1, copper 2 will be copper plus and copper 2 plus. The exception here will be the zinc ion and silver ion because they already have their own charge, zinc being a 2 plus charge and silver being a plus 1 charge. There are also some common polyatomic positive ions that we should memorize. So there's an ammonium cation. It is NH4+. Okay, so this one we have to memorize by heart.